What's going on, guys? It's Sam, and today I'm going to show you how to make an animated social media lower third in Adobe Premiere Pro. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to create social media lower thirds for YouTube, how to animate a lower third in Adobe Premiere Pro, and how to create lower thirds for any social media handle. Alright guys, as always, you can download this motion graphics template down in the description below. It says, get this animation as a template. This template was inspired by Asher John. He reached out to me, asked for to make some social media lower thirds and turn it into a template, and I was like, let's do it. So if you have any suggestions, just go ahead and leave it in the comments. Alright guys, so let's go ahead and dive in. So first, I'm going to make an Instagram lower third, and we're going to do that by using the Essential Graphics panel inside of Premiere Pro. So if you don't have it open, it's under Window. You can just go down and click on Essential Graphics. Okay, and then we're going to click on this new layer button, and we're going to click on From File. And so I already have the Instagram logo right here. I'm going to double click it, and it's in now. So basically, I created an Essential Graphics layer with the Instagram logo in it. Okay, so if I click on it, you can see it's just chilling inside of the Essential Graphics, and I'm going to make it down, size it down maybe to like, I don't know. Yeah, size 13 seems about right. All right, and then next I'm going to create the bar that I want like the handle to be on, and also the name of the person that we're gonna create the handle for. So let's click on new layer again, go to rectangle, all right? And then we've got a rectangle here. I'm going to actually, so there's already a stroke on mine. If there isn't, go ahead and turn it on. I made mine last time 66 width. So I'm just gonna roll with that, click on the little wrench here, and you'll see the graphics properties. So let's change it from milter join to round join, because I want it to have like the rounded corners effect. You can see the box's rounded corners now. So I'm gonna click on the shape again inside of my central graphics panel. I'm going to just kind of make this small so that it kind of fits right in with the size. Move this anchor point of the Instagram logo. Okay, so I'm just gonna put it right there. Probably shrink this down a bit. Put this right in the middle. Okay, and then we're gonna change the order of the layers in the Essential Graphics panel, put Instagram on top, okay? And so now we've got the shape here, make sure it's lined up with Instagram. There we go, and if you're not getting those little lines for Snap and Program Monitor, it's right here. Just click on the little wrench in the Program Monitor, and where is it? Snap and Program Monitor, there we go. Now that we have our graphic selected, hit the slash above Enter to make that. All right, so we kind of have our lower third now, so let's go ahead and add some text, okay? And I'm going to make this say, at your name. Okay, I'm gonna click on the selection tool. I'm just gonna like shrink this down so it just kind of fits right in there. I'm gonna center this text as well, and then just scoot it so that's in the middle of the white. Now, it would be nice for all this to animate on. First, I'm going to turn off the shape and the your name. I'm just going to focus on Instagram, okay? So let's go to the effect controls and let's open up the Instagram. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the effects and I'm going to type in transform. And we are going to add a transform effect above everything, okay? And we're going to change the shutter angle to about 200. And we are going to put a keyframe for rotation. Click on uniform scale and scale, okay? So I'm gonna have this start at zero scale, and I'm gonna have it start at like negative, I don't know, 60 degrees. And then we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Maybe we'll go to, let's go to 8 frames, and then let's bring the scale up to 100, and then reset the rotation, okay? And then I'm going to have these ease in. All right, let's see how this looks. Damn, look at that. So the Instagram logo just kind of pops on. And I think right after we have it pop on, maybe at like 12, this is when I want that bar to come in, okay? So I'm going to turn on the shape and I'm gonna have it move on, okay? So let's go to transform, click on the position, and let's go maybe like 8 frames over. Oh wait, that would be 18 frames, and then let's put a keyframe where it is, and let's go back to the first keyframe and pull it off. Okay, see how it's going to the left of the Instagram logo? I'm actually going to hide that by doing this cool little trick. I'm gonna create another shape. All right, so here's this shape here. I'm just gonna extend it out, I'm gonna pull it, put it halfway in the Instagram logo, all right? And then what I'm gonna do is I'm going to scroll down and go mask with shape and click invert. All right, and then I'm just gonna put it above the shape layer. So now, when we go back to the effect controls, and we see when we play it, look, the bar shows up. Yay! All right, let me temporal interpolation ease in. Look at that. So we got popping on, social media lower third. Then I'm just going to have the text just pop on. I'm gonna have it just fade on. I think that would kind of make things pretty nice and easy. So let's put that at 0, and then we'll go to 108, put it up to 100. All right. There we go, Instagram handle. And then I'm gonna go ahead and reverse all of these animations. All right, so as you can see, I reversed all the animations. So Instagram pops on, handle pops on, bar goes away, Instagram goes away, okay? All right guys, so you can go ahead and create a social media lower third just like this with any other logo that you'd like. So feel free to add in Twitter or YouTube or Pinterest or Facebook, whatever you wanna use to create a lower third out of. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. You can always get the template down below by clicking the link in the description. It's got YouTube and Facebook and Twitter and all of them built into it. So you can just go ahead and snag that template and use it really easily. I also wanna let you guys know about my YouTube Motion Graphics Academy. I just created a Facebook group to help build excitement before the launch. I'm doing live workshops in there and Q&A, so go ahead and join that if you want to get better at creating motion graphics for your YouTube channel. And the last thing I wanna leave you guys with is the next video, which is my subscribe button that I made for you guys. So go ahead and watch that. It's a free download as well, and the tutorial. So give that video a watch, and I will see you guys next time.